Well, preseason really is the time for us to come together. I mean, it's all of our new folks are coming in. Our returners are coming back from being all over the country training and getting ready for the cross country season. So the preseason really for us is that time again when we can come together. We go to Mountain Lake Lodge down in Southwest Virginia, incredible place, amazing trails and mountains. So we're up out of the humidity. Typically it's 10 to 15 degrees cooler there, so we can get lots of good training in, run along the New River, just lots of reasons to go there. Another of which is that there's a lot less distractions there. No TVs, cell phone use is a minimal because there's just not service, and just really is a great place for us to go and get our preseason training in.
Well, overall toughness and strength is really the core to cross country running. I mean, no matter what the course looks like, there's going to come a point in the race where you're going to have to be stronger, tougher, and just more relentless than your opponent. And so at the beginning of the season as well, we're trying to build on that strength. That's the foundation of our training. So, and then this year, the A-10 Championships, George Mason is hosting it up at Oatlands. And then our regional NCAA qualifier is in Charlottesville. Both are hilly courses.
You lose three top 10 runners from the A-10 championship of last year. You've won three out of four championships. And even though you lose all those people, you're still picked number one. It's a testimony to the program, right?
Yeah, we have a really strong group of girls that have been working really hard over the summer from seniors all the way down to freshmen. It's really exciting to have a great group of freshmen that are able to jump right in and contribute right away. And then we also have some girls who have gotten a lot of experience over the last couple of years who I expect will make really big jumps this season and really come in and fill those gaps from the girls who have graduated.
We can't replace the ones that we have, but we can certainly do our best to get people that are in a position to be able to get in there in terms of their ability and the way they look at what they want to accomplish here at this level. So really fortunate, the four ladies that joined us at camp are in great shape, had great, come off of high school careers with on the track and in cross country that really have separated themselves, not only within their state, but nationally. It's nice to have a group of freshmen that really can work together and has that expectation.
The freshmen that ran last year are now sophomores. You were back. Your thoughts on the 2019 cross country season?
I'm excited. A lot of the returning sophomores have made big strides over the summer. I'm really excited at where their fitness level is at right now. And lots of the returners as well, just another year stronger. I think it'll be a good year.
The sophomore in the sophomore class have really elevated their level of fitness over the summer. They've gotten in quite a few miles and really worked on it. Of course, Miles has been in Colorado this summer and I think had a great summer of training there. And then our freshmen coming in looking pretty strong as well. So right now we've got a very cohesive group and close together. So, we really don't know who our top five and top seven is going to be at this point. So that's a good thing. Over time, we think that'll certainly get separated out, and we're really looking forward to the season coming together.